Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Ronnie here again from Kickback Garage. Now, this is number 376.3 of the Lambretta TV175 rebuild series. Something like that. I think it's 17. And today we are going to be fitting the front mudguard and the horncast. I'm quite looking forward to that because then it's going to start looking like a proper scooter. So if that's something you have, you fancy having a watch of, then grab yourself a coffee or maybe something even stronger today and I'll send the scooter over. What? I can never figure out if it's that way. What? Or that way. What? You never know. Right, people. As you can see in front of you here, we have got the beautifully painted horncast and mudguard. Now, on the Series 2 horncast, there is two fixing screws on the bottom here, so that it makes life easier. If you actually attach the horncast to the mudguard and offer that up as one piece. But, as we see here, the Series 3 has just got the two fixing points, so that means we're gonna have to do it the old-fashioned way, and that means offering up the mudguard to the frame and bolting it down very loosely, and then fitting the horncast and sort of moving it around a little bit, jiggling it around just so it fits nicely. Right, so first job is first job on the agenda is these beautiful looking, as far as rubber gaskets can go, handsome looking mudguard rubbers that I got from Screwtopia. What I think I'm going to do to make my life easier, because if you're trying to fit this and put screws in and this is just going to flap around, I've only got one pair of hands. What I think I'm actually going to do here is I'm going to use a little bit of silicone gasket sealer, just that was a bit too much actually, but just give me some splodges. I don't want this sticking out the edges, but it's simply just to glue down the gaskets a little bit, just so that they don't flap around. That's a bit annoying, isn't it? That hole is way out. Can you see that bottom hole there? Does that mean I'm going to have to cut another hole in the bottom of the gasket? Let's have a look. Ah, lovely. Well, that was that plan foiled. Yeah, that hole is miles out. That is a little bit frustrating. I'm actually gonna have to take the knife and cut out the inch there. Oh, come on, how wide is it, Rob? Right. Let's see if we can stick that. Made a little keyhole there, didn't I? Huh? Artist impression. Right. It does want to stick, which is good. So that means I could be lucky with this. There you go. All right, you bugger. I can see this going to be a pin. Right, so when you're fixing the mudguard here, you've got these fancy washers here that sit on the back side of the leg shield there, so it looks pretty. So I'll fit that in there. I'm gonna try and offer it up. Oh, you brake cable. Boy. Not fun. Please don't fall off. Oh, boy. Bolt number two on, very, very loosely. I think I can tighten those down a little bit. But where are the rubber? Where is the rubber? Here it is. Annoyingly, that front brake cable is in the way. Right, so the inner lip of the gasket here, it interferes with the cables, and the cables are in the correct place. So I think I'm gonna just measure that out. It's not really that important. I think I'm gonna measure that out and just cut off this outer lip here, basically just to make things easier for me. Where are my scissors? Is that gonna help, do you reckon? Ish. Helps ish. Right. This is having absolutely none of it. And on inspection, this was some. Let me tell you a story. When we bought this scooter, it was already painted, and it was painted in 1990, and it's been stored in boxes. So when we bought it, it was another color, but yeah. So we didn't have a chance to give it a dry build. So this is when you find out that you haven't done a dry build, when you find out stuff like this. But anyway, what's happened is this has been, it's either been warped because of sandblasting, or it's been trodden on or something. And the leading edge here, this is bent down so it doesn't line up with the holes in the top. And it's about a centimeter out on the holes on the leg shield. So I'll just throw a picture up here. I took a picture of it. I'll just throw it up here. And as you can see, the holes are way off. Now, I talked to the owner, and because paint in Norway is so expensive, we decided that we're just gonna, without heating it up, probably need a lot of heat to be able to bend this one out. But just to see if we could get away with it, we tried bending it back. Now, we'd moved it about 2 or 3 millimeters, and that wasn't any problem at all. And then, no! Shit! So the depressing thing about that is I'm going to have to order a new one, and that'll take at least 2 or 3 weeks, I reckon. Oi! Perfect! Right, so this is exciting stuff, to tell you the truth. I ordered this from Rimini Lambretta yesterday, and they offer next day delivery to Norway. So although it's a little bit more expensive, the annoying thing with those fellas is that they don't take away the EU VAT. So I end up paying about 25% more. But as you saw there, postage is extremely fast. The strange thing is that this is a bit of a gamble, because on the website to Rimini and Castle Lambretta, it says this is only for non-chrome ring scooters. And as you know, we've got the old chrome ring going on here. A long discussion on my Facebook page, Kickbike Garage. If you don't follow that, jump over there and go there too. Loads of inside information, by the way. And the fellas there are saying the only difference really between the non-chrome ring and the chrome ring scooters, Series 3s, is the fact that the headset has got a bit more of a cutout, so they've got room for the chrome ring. So even though I sent them an email and asked Rimini if this will fit, they said no. I took a massive gamble, and I'm hoping it'll do the job. So let's get this open and have a look. Quite excited, actually. It's a bit depressing that we have to use money on this, but the problem with this scooter is that we bought it already painted, and it was painted in the 90s. I think it's probably been sandblasted to death or something like that, or it's just been sat around. There was no marks on the paint or anything, but it was definitely deformed. Now, ooh, looks... the finish looks really nice. And when I line them up together, minus the lug, when I line them up together... they look pretty much identical. The bolt holes are at the same height, and even the lugs on the casting are in the same place. So that's promising. One thing, I'm not sure if you can see this, but one thing I noticed here is... If I line up the hole on the top here, because the holes didn't fit on my scooter, because this is bent, you can see it's out by a country mile at the top there. Now that might be savable, but it's obviously been pressed in here on along the whole of this side here, and it was this lug here that was pressed in. But anyway, stop talking. Let's do some doing. So let's see if this will fit. I'm a bit excited. What do you reckon? Can you see? If I move the camera here. Let's have a look. That would be nice, wouldn't it, if I scratch the paint. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure that the holes line up, and then I'm going to take this down to the new owner, and he's going to get it painted. Wow, let's have a look. Oh, wow. It fits really nicely on the two holes at the front on the mudguard. There is no interference on the... with the headset, so that's good. That's what I was worried about. I checked the two holes behind. And wow. They line up pretty much perfectly on the back here. Because that has to, yeah. Either I can massage this a tiny bit, I think they're about 1 millimeter out on both the holes. So if I put it on one side there, It's hardly nothing. So what I think I'll do there, instead of risking trying to bend that out a little bit, I think I'm going to and splay it. I think I'll actually file the hole on one of the sides there a tiny little bit. But it fits perfectly on these holes. And the top holes are also perfect. So that's pretty good. Although that means that I won't be fitting this today. It means that I don't have to think about it and I can sleep well at night again. So I'll call this one a day, even though it didn't finish what I wanted to do. I'll call this a day and do the old subscribe, give me a thumbs up, comments down below, and I'll see you in the next video. What am I going to do in the next video? I have no idea. We'll see. Okay, lads, I'll see you later. Ta-ra! So, Dedus Gayo. Är kasta den till mig. Nu har jag lagt fram mig detta.
Ja.
Hä?
Är det på?
Ja.
Ja,
okej. Ett har jag lagt den fram mig.
Ja.
Sant? Ja. So basically that means you have to order a new one. Oh. And that's going to take ages. Vi tar den igen. Så det det är vanskligt när man har audiens. Du menar